In our last example, we created this sewer grate with a bunch of perforated holes in it. You'll notice, though, that our holes aren't centered, and so we want to go ahead and modify this to make a little bit better drawing. I'm going to start by deleting our linear array that we created, and then I'm going to modify the our extrusion drawing to make it a little bit more what we're looking for. So I really am going to put this guy, this hole, right in the center of the part, and I can do that by right-clicking on an edge and then selecting the midpoint. Hold down Control and select the center point of the circle, and you'll see a little flyout menu, and put a relation to make it vertical. And then I can right-click on this edge over here, select the midpoint, and then Control-click on the center of the circle and make those horizontal. Now our circle's fully defined in the center of the sketch. I'm also going to add two center lines at this point. So I'll add a vertical center line as well as a horizontal center line. Okay. Now what I'm going to do is I'll re-add my linear pattern back in, and I'm going to choose the direction, and I'll choose the spacing. I'm going to space it at 3 inches again, and we'll go with 3 for now. And then I'm going to also choose the second direction. Oops. And I'll go for a spacing of 3 inches. And I'm going to zoom in here and go ahead and pick my hole to be extruded. Okay, now I have three holes that are all in the left-hand corner here, and that's just fine. I'll leave that there. And what I'm going to do is now I can mirror that pattern about those lines that I created. And it's actually going to be looking for a face, so this is a good time for us to learn how to input a plane. So I'll insert plane. And actually, we can probably do this by just using the original planes that are on the part. Well, let's go ahead and add a plane anyway. So if we add a plane, I'm going to go ahead and select the midpoint of this line, and we can see it puts one in there, and I'll just accept that and say that's fine. Oh, it wants us to give us a second reference point, so I'm going to give it another point here and another point there, which is enough to define a plane, 3 points to define a plane. And I'll add another piece of reference geometry, another plane that's orthogonal to this plane, and I can just click on perpendicular, and that's not quite the way we want. So I'm going to undo that, and I'm going to click for a different piece of reference geometry. I'll go ahead and click that point, this point, and I'll click 1/3 midpoint, and I've got a fully defined plane there. Okay, so I've defined these two planes. I can go ahead and click on mirror, and what I want to go ahead and do, it's already pre-selected that last plane I made, and I want it. It says to select the features to mirror, so I'll go ahead and click, find my linear pattern, and it will mirror about that plane. I click on check, and it's done. And I can repeat the same process, and I'm going to choose this other plane. It already looks at the previous feature I made and mirrors all of those, okay? So that's how to use the mirror for features. Instead of looking for a line, it looks for a plane, so you have to insert reference geometry, and you can create two planes that way.